I don't remember how many acts there are in this game.
Oh. Weird.
Yeah. Alright. Let's continue. Either way, gotta keep pushing forward. Looks somewhat similar to another Diablo map. Really weird. Oh god, these guys. Oh, I stunned him. I didn't know I could stun those big guys. That's cool. Gargoyles. It's a force grid. Destroy tree. Oh. Oh, another big guy. Gargoyles to attack me. Oh, I guess he's the only one. Are you alive too? I guess the only ones that will attack me are the ones that don't have the vines over them. So, visibly, I'll know which ones will attack me, like this one. Dead Island 2? Oh, I swore, like, later, like, earlier today, I thought it was Dying Light 2. I actually get to see some Dead Island 2 stuff? Must have misread it. I was like, that or unless, like, Dead Island 2 and Dying Light 2 playable stuff. Oh, it was a 2015 footage? I'd still like to see it. See what they had in mind of Dead Island 2. Is that what? Like, Dead Island 2 was a project that got bounced around so much by so many, like, developers. Yeah, we're not gonna see Dead Island 2. To be honest, here's the thing. I never liked the Dead Island series because combat was kind of shit. Didn't like it. It was very just meh. I enjoy playing Dying Light instead of Dead Island. Wait, Last of Us? What are you talking about? Last of Us is Naughty Dog. Oh, you mean by story-wise? Oh yeah, because of their whole trailer with Dead Island. Yeah, that's true. I guess I'm missing the context there. I was like, wait a minute, wait, what? I'm so confused. It's like, oh yeah, because you're talking about their first trailer for Dead Island, which made it look like it was gonna have a very powerful story and everything, and then they didn't. And then everyone learned that you cannot trust a trailer at all. You can't trust a fucking trailer, even if your life depended on it. Shit, this guy will not go down. There we go. Oh, we can breathe a bit. Oh yeah, I think I was one of those people that were incredibly pissed off at the developers of Dead Island. Because I think when everyone, I don't know if they released any more like detail of Dead Island after that trailer, before it released. But I think everyone was completely shocked of how different the game was compared to that trailer. Feeling wise, like, the story was clearly pretty bad. Yeah, if you compare it. The gameplay was kind of there when it came to at least some fun factors, but overall it felt like more of a slog than anything. You were expecting more of a Last of Us style game with a deep story? Nope. Not with the Dead Island dudes. I mean, even Dying Light doesn't really have that great of a story. That's another Deep Silver game, isn't it? Or published by Deep Silver. But, yeah. Huh. Oh, it's locked. Okay. Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. They probably knew that if Dying Light was actually marketed of a game that it truly was, it wouldn't have done as good as it did. And thanks to its controversy and all that too, it actually sold more than it should have. Because you see, like, you know, you kind of see, like, I guess the re-releases for the current generation of consoles and stuff like that. It's like, who's buying that? Who's buying the Dead Island definitive editions? I guess there are people doing it, because people did still have fun with the game. But I will never forget how they tried to con millions of gamers into thinking that it had a good story. And it's just true, because they didn't really do much. They didn't have to do much. Especially if they even, what, they think they went through probably some third party people to do the remakes. Or not remakes, but because they weren't remakes, remasters. The remake means an absolute overhaul. Remaster is mainly just upping the graphics, fixing bugs, stuff like that. There we go. there's a lot of new indie studios that basically take third-party contracts, even 3D Realms. Really? Oh yeah, that's true. Yeah, well, that's the thing. When you're in between games, you would have had to pick up a lot of stuff. Like, I think even Ubisoft back then did a lot of the kind of like contract deals. Hell, I think they even did a lot of software stuff back then as well. In between, like, developing games. Well, before Ubisoft became Ubisoft. Squaresoft and... I forgot, what was the other company that became Ubisoft? It was Squaresoft and something else. Then I... Yeah. I don't know. I forgot what the other company was called. It was that long ago since they became Ubisoft. Or did they just change their name completely? I'm thinking of someone else. So if I remember correctly, I think Square Enix used to be called Squaresoft. Or I'm thinking of another company. When EA used to actually make good games. I'm like an asshole saying that, but... It's true, man! It's fucking true! He used to publish some cool-ass shit back then. And now they're too tight-knit. They don't want to be experimental and publish really cool shit. Unless it's like an indie developer that they don't have a lot of money into. So they're totally okay with indie developers being experimental. But they can't spend too much money on, like, experimental new IPs and shit. I know where to go. It's like, you know what I'm kind of hoping for still? Is IO Interactive to do something with the Freedom Fighters IP they have. They still own it. Or they like bought it a few years ago. I think Square Enix. Squeenix. Oh my god, I'm so slow. Make sure I'm not missing anything. 768 base damage. Not bad. Could do better though. Could do better. Wait a minute, what is that? Oh. Guessing I'm having to find those for something. I wonder if the Earth one's down here. Is there an Earth one, but then the Fire Nation attacked? Earth, wind, fire, water. Don't forget about heart, because Captain Planet would not be completed without heart. Even though that's nothing to deal with planet. Captain Planet was weird, but I still liked it.
You have gained an experience.
Captain Planet didn't really make a lot of sense, but I still enjoyed the damn show. Why not? We know we're talking about all this nostalgic shit today. Just being in a nostalgic mood, talking about old things we used to like and disliked. It's like, man, like my favorite game on the Xbox. Original Xbox. I think it was original Xbox. Yeah, original Xbox was Freedom Fighters. That shit was the bomb. I fucking loved it because it was like, it was a different game that the Hitman developers actually worked on that was truly actually really good. Like, yeah, maybe the shooting wasn't the best, but damn was that game fun. The concept of being able to like be tactical freedom fighters and shit like that. That was really cool. Defending like New York, and I think he even went to New Jersey at times. But yeah, spoilers by the way, the some of the end fights near Ellis Island and on Ellis Island was actually pretty cool. Then they left the damn series with a cliffhanger. It's like, will we get our country back from the Russians? I don't know. I'll never know because they didn't finish the series. I don't even know if they wanted to make it into a series. It seemed like they did, the way they ended freaking Freedom Fighters. It's like it was like Red Dawn, but with a better story. Ooh, sorry if you liked that movie, but Freedom Fighters actually had a better story. And that's a game. It was more impactful. Actually, I need to rewatch that movie to see if the story is super corny now, or if it actually holds up. It's like, does the story of Red Dawn hold up? Be back at 11. Lock chest? No. Ah, fuck. Oh, he had something. Of course, I'm probably gonna forget about it because I don't know who has the damn key. Uh-oh. Are we spider territory? Where's the spiders? Where's the enemies? There we are. It's weird. There's only like two spiders in that whole section. Altar. Ooh. Oh shit, there's a lot on the map. Fuck. Well, one thing at a time, ladies and gents. One thing at a goddamn time. When your map looks overwhelming, just take it one step. Keep focused. Keep pushing. And you'll clean your map eventually. Kinda like with any open world map. Your map looks incredibly intimidating after 10 hours and after you got most of the stuff like introduced to you, and your map looks like hell. But once you start cleaning it up, you start to feel proud of yourself. Then after 30 or 40 hours of doing the same shit over and over again, you start to hate yourself. But yet you're still proud of yourself because the map's cleaner. That's my experience with open world games. That was pretty much my experience with like Mad Max for the past like month. I was cleaning up that map, But goddamn did I hate myself at the end of it. It's like, I don't know if it was worth it. Like, I love Mad Max. It's a fantastic fucking game. But holy shit, is it not worth completing the game? I gave up on it. I gave up on trying to 100% it. It's like, I don't have the patience. I have my cutoff point. My cutoff point was once I got to where I needed to complete all the races with all, like, archangels, and also complete all the challenges in that game. It's like, nah, I'd rather move on to the next game. I had my fill of Mad Max. Now I moved on to another open world game, which is Death Stranding. I plan on trying to 100% that game until I find my my cutoff point. Like, here's the thing, like, if I was still trying to 100% games like I was in high school, I probably would have had the, I probably would have had the patience to 100% Mad Max, but now that I'm older and I have a shit ton of things to do on and off stream, nah, my patience is very little when it comes to doing stuff like that anymore. Unless I drop art or some other things, then maybe. But now that I'm trying to be more of a well-rounded person when it comes to things I do on and off stream, I can't have that. I can't spend endless hours just playing games anymore. Even though I would like to. I'm trying not to. Because, you know, I am married now. I can't be doing that shit. You gotta be productive at all times. 100%. What would Laura think of me if I just played games for the rest of my life? I gotta do something. Fight mechanical dudes. What's this?
My pack is full. I can't carry any more.
Fuck. I hate that. I really hate that there's a lot of games out there that still think, oh, hey, having over encumbrance or an item limit is a smart thing. It's only a smart thing if you're survival fucking horror. When you're an RPG like this, please don't let us have item limit. I hate this so much. It just ruins the pacing. Still love this game. Fuck it. I guess this is level 40. Nah. Even though that helmet looks cooler, I say nah. Actually, no. Our current helmet's pretty cool. Let's see. Which is the one I want to replace? The blue one? The blue one. Place that blue one, put it there. Ooh, oh, big old boner. I got the DPS. DPS has went up tenfold. Well, 40 points, but still. It's amazing how many, like, how little of a point upgrade actually matters in this game, though. It's like, out of all the other, like, ARPGs I played in the past years, like Diablo 3 and Path of Exiles and all that, these numbers look so minuscule compared to those games, but they make bigger differences when they're just like 20 points difference. It's like, buddy. Wait a minute, I have two of these now. Oh, is it the same thing? No, different. Ooh, crit chance. Anything that increases my crit chance a little bit, I will take that instead. Because I would like to have it to where I can do a good amount of crit percentage. So, that would be nice. Also, I have a slot on this weapon. I need to figure out what I'm going to put. Probably flame. Flame damage is always nice to do. Alright, pet. See you later. Also got a slot in my chest armor I just got. Oh shit, he's trying to attack me through the tree? That is rude. War troll. An asshole. Unless it broke his armor, that's why it took more damage. Oh, I can enchant now too. Oh, come on. I'm trying to enchant here.
Fortune smiles upon
you. Ooh. I think I like that. Okay, cool. Thanks. Thanks for the enchantment. Block? What are you blocking that? Weapon's still a two-hander. It's not pulsating, so I don't need to go to it right now, but we gotta go through portals. Oh, hi. Oh! Oh, I thought I went through the portal again.
Not enough mana.
Not enough mana. Come on. I mean, once I actually spawn him, I won't have a mana problem. Me and my mana problems. Jeez. I could never invest the points in mana or something. I probably should put more points into mana. Just for the sake of, like, being able to whip out my abilities whenever I need it. What do I do? Ecor pod. Ecor pod. My sword is looking pretty different now. So ethereal. Just like my hammer. I wonder if that's what it did. That enchantment. Eh, I should probably go back and see what was over there. That's gonna bug me if I don't. I have a feeling this place will have a portal at the end of it. Let's see, what's this? Oh, I guess it's nothing. I love it that Lara does her own commentary when she's playing games in the other room. You can, like, I can hear her make comments on the games, like, talk about how it's like, how could you not hit this? She's gotten a twitch bug. Oh, something is stealing my mana. Well, that was weird. I saw it jump up and down. Doing your own self-commentary, Lar? Self-commentary.